Therefore, imperative that we urgently address our economic situation through the 2018 budget. And some of the measures we need to take are to restore market confidence, to instill and uphold discipline in managing our public finances and the economy as a whole, as well as ensuring policy consistency, clarity, credibility, and predictability. The budget makes a bold statement on the adoption of a paradigm shift towards, and I quote, towards a new economic order, drawing from the inaugural speech by His Excellency the President, Comrade M.D. Mnangagwa, on 24th November 2017. Mr. Speaker, restoring market confidence remains extremely important to the country's recovery process. Accordingly, we strive to institute measures necessary to deal with the following issues: cash shortages, including foreign exchange generation, unsustainable fiscal budget deficit, corruption and indiscipline. We need to address the issue of international re-engagement. We need to create an investor-friendly business environment. And lastly, we need to ensure credibility in the conduct of the 2018 harmonized general elections. With respect to cash shortages, including foreign exchange generation, Mr. Speaker, in our dollarized economy, foreign currency generation, particularly exports, is critical for liquidity. However, notwithstanding improvement in export performance, the economy faces a mismatch between electronic balances in the banks and actual foreign currency available. Mr. Speaker, the government is cognizant of the frustrations and hardships that our people are experiencing due to the prevailing cash shortages. Mr. Speaker, the shortage of cash is a symptom of many challenges facing the economy. Therefore, adequately addressing this issue requires that we confront the underlying causes, particularly low confidence, that is negatively affecting the efficient circulation of cash in the economy. Accordingly, in the short to medium term, our options revolve around the following. We need to increase use of plastic and mobile money by enhancing and extending electronic payment platforms to rural areas. We need to review charges on plastic and mobile money transactions. We need to promote external inflows, including diaspora remittances. We need to import cash within the limits of our costs. We also need to enforce acceptance by traders of payments through plastic and mobile money. And above all, we need to review taxes on electronic payment systems to promote wider use.